smelling that fresh air just makes me wanna do this video. Yeah. Today we're gonna talk about the Sony 24 to 105 millimeter lens F4. Hello and welcome back to another exciting video on my channel. If you're new to my channel, my name is Bennett Gracer and I create videos here on YouTube. Whether it's reviewing gear or giving you filmmaking tips, my goal is to help you create better videos. So if that's what you're looking for, then keep on watching. I can tell you from the start that this baby is amazing. If I only could have one lens, then it would definitely pick up the 24 to 105. Especially when you're on the run and have no time to change lenses, this lens offers a really good range going from 24 to 105. Now this lens is quite expensive and cost a whopping $1,200. That hurts. I guess I have to sell all of my equipment. Now there is a cheaper option, which would be the Tamron 28-75 f2.8 that costs around $825. That hurts. But there is still even a cheaper option, which I will get to it later. Now let's make a quick comparison of the Tamron and the Sony. So the 24-105 offers 50% more zoom range than the 24-70. Yes, you will lose a stop of light, but shooting with the Sony a7 III that offers good low light capabilities, using F4 won't be a big of a problem. I have taken this lens with me to Venice and have been shooting with it about 90% of the time. The constant F4 aperture makes it easy to use when shooting in video mode, because when changing the focal length, I don't always have to adjust my exposure. The autofocus works very nicely when shooting in good lighting conditions. It's very fast and silent and accurate. I just love shooting video with this lens. Now the lens produces a very sharp and beautiful image, and with the aperture f4, when zooming in with the lens, you can get some really nice bokeh in the background. Now the f4 aperture won't give you that 1.8 shallow background, but for my preference, I still like the f4 of it. Now when holding the lens in my hand, I can feel that the build quality is very solid and is made out of plastic. The focusing and zooming part is made out of a rubber ring, which gives me better control and feels very nice when gripping it. The lens is also partly weather sealed, which makes it good for traveling. Now on the side of the lens, you will find one switch for controlling the focus mode and the other switching for image stabilization. Now the image stabilization does a great job, but you need to know that it takes practice when shooting handheld. The image stabilization can't compensate all of your shaky movements like a GH5, so make sure you work with your body. I actually made a tutorial about shooting steady handheld shots, which I will link up here. Now, the cool part of this lens is that it has a custom button on the side, which can be very handy. I have my custom button set to manual focus, so whenever I press and hold the button, it will set to manual focus. When I release the button, it will switch back to autofocus. This comes in handy when I want to create a revealing shot, not wanting to have my foreground in focus. Now, this lens is meant for full frame cameras. If you shoot with an APS-C sensor, then I would recommend buying the 18-105, which is way cheaper and costs around $600. Is that cheap? You could actually also use that lens on the Sony a7 III since it offers a Super 35 crop mode. So to wrap this up, the 24-105 F4 is built to last. It offers a very nice bokeh, is fairly lightweighted, and has a good range when shooting on the run. I can't really say anything bad about this lens except for the price. Thank you so much guys for watching. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any further questions, please let me know in the comment section below. I will try to answer all of them as good as I can. Appreciate you watching my videos and hopefully see you the next time.